Hello, welcome here on this first Working with France session. I'm Stéphane Bender, I'm the interim CEO of Film France, the French National Film Commission, and we are really happy to welcome you here on this Working with France information session. This is our first session, and I guess if you are here with us, it's because you have a project with France. Maybe you intend to work with a French partner, maybe you have some script which involves filming in France. And I have a good news for you. It is, you are going to meet the three of our top experts who are going to give you all the information you need to make your project successful. So please let me introduce you firstly to Magali Armand from the National Center for Cinema, and to Laurie Hades and Matthew Parker from Film France. So this is going to be, we're going to have two presentations. One thing I can tell you is the best way to process would be that you would ask your questions during the presentations and we will answer to them afterwards. So maybe Matthew, you could give us some information about the current situation in France.
Sure. First of all, since the beginning of May, film permits are once again being issued and shoots are allowed to go ahead. As part of the response to the crisis, a temporary indemnity fund has been set up by the French Ministry of Culture and the CNC, the Center for Cinema, to support French production and to help them adapt to the new sanitary situation. We also have clear guidelines which are available to producers and filmmakers to ensure compliance with new safety rules.
Yeah, and restrictions on travel to France from neighboring European countries have not been lifted. For the Americas, we are working successfully to obtain waiver from the French government in order to allow production to enter the territory. Border reopen, production are rescheduling their shoots and returning to France. As big proof, we currently have a large British crew who were able to travel to the overseas territories of Guadeloupe last week in order to prep for their shoot in July. Some feedback from production already shooting is extremely positive.
And last but not least, we're very pleased to announce that as of today, cinemas in France are allowed to reopen. So it's safe to say the French film industry is back up and running.
Yeah, and ready to shoot.
So let's talk about let's talk about the tax rebate for international production.
Yes, thank you, Stéphane. Is that okay?
It is.
Okay, so there is two ways of working with France. We have the official co-production that will be presented by Magali later on. All state French subsidies will go to co-producer, and there is dedicated co-production schemes, 58, I think, but Magali will say more. And there is a tax rebate for international production related with a production services company, and it's 50 or 40 tax rebate on eligible spend. So let's get with the trip. First of all, Film France, who we are. We are the French Film Commission, and we provide free services for all producers who want to shoot or to work in France. And we can rely on a network of 32 film commissions all over France, including overseas territories. And we are providing expertise on the tax rebate for international production and assessing projects' eligibility. So what we do, we are the one-stop shop for all the production. We are providing information about location, regulation, technical facilities, line producer. We are helping her production to work in France. So as we say, currently we are working with a lot to help foreign talent and crew to cross the border. And it works because the British crew were able to travel to overseas territories of Guadeloupe, and they are now preparing their shooting. One thing very relevant for you is that we are assisting all the producers to apply for the TRIP, so tax rebate for international production.
So what is the TRIP? Well, I think we can gather by now that it's generous. You can get between 30 or now even 40% tax rebate on your eligible spends in France. But it's also simple. There's no red tape. You simply need to bring a deal memo, a script, and a first estimate of your budget when applying for the TRIP. The TRIP is also reliable. The production service company collects the TRIP every year from the French tax services. It's also fast. You can start spending the day you send the application to the CNC for provisional qualification within 3 weeks. You can now also get a brand new 10% bonus, which we will talk about in more detail later on.
So what kind of projects are qualifying? We are talking about live action, animation, VFX, VR, feature film, short film, VFX, post-production. We're talking about also series, single or the whole season, web, OTT or TV, and for all budgets. Please note that documentaries and commercials are not eligible. And all the projects have to be scripts. So what are the criteria? You have to spend a minimum of 250,000 euro, or the half of your total budget, whichever is the lowest. You have to work with a French PSC, but we will talk about it later. For live action projects, you need 5 days of shooting. Please note that there is no filming required, of course, for VFX and animation. You have to pass a cultural test, but it's pretty easy to pass. As for example, we read Mission Impossible, The Hunger Games, The Minions for animation. In VFX, Blade Runner, American Gods, and The Kingsman.
So how do you access the TRIP? Well, it's available through a company that is subject to corporate income tax in France. This company acts as your production service company. They receive the TRIP through their yearly tax returns. Now, this company can be either an existing company, it can be a subsidiary of the foreign production, or as we call it, a special purpose vehicle, an SPV. We also have an online production service company database, which includes hundreds of professionals working in France. They work regularly with the TRIP across a wide range of projects and genres and in a variety of languages. That's on the Film France website. You can come at any time of year to apply for the TRIP. Here's the timeline, sort of whittled down into a few words. First of all, your production service company requests provisional qualification from the CNC. This is all done digitally. This requires minimal formalities. As I mentioned earlier, you just bring a script, bring a deal memo, and a first budget estimate. Once this application is sent, you can start spending, or your PSC can start spending. The CNC then issues your provisional qualification within 3 weeks. Greenlit projects get the money every year from the tax authorities through your PSC, as I've already mentioned. And then at the end of the project, the PSC requests a final qualification from the CNC. This has to be a maximum of 2 years after the last French expense. The CNC then issues your final qualification within 8 weeks.
So now, what is eligible? First of all, salaries, wages of European writers and actors, plus social contribution. You have to know that it's capped and mainly for actors. Salaries paid for the French or the European direction and production staff. Wages and incidentals plus social contribution. There is no cap. Expenditure for technical goods and services based in France, including VFX, animation and post-production facilities, and also there is no cap. Renting the location and construction sets are also eligible. Accommodation, catering, travel of all cast and crew, it's capped. Transport of materials and all the depreciation expenses. So, how much do you get when your project qualifies? As we say, there is a cap of 30 million, which means you will have had 100 million euro eligible. If you have such a project, you are, of course, very welcome. One thing to notice, if you plan to spend, let's say, 1 million in France, but you change your mind and you decide to spend twice as much, you will have more money, and the rate will be 30% on all. And the big news is that now you can reach up to 40% on all eligible expenses if you get a 10% VFX related bonus. So I'm sure that's all that you want to know, how to get this 10% bonus.
Yes, so this is the basic rule about the new 10% bonus. It goes to qualifying projects which are VFX intensive projects. So that means they spend more than 2 million euros in eligible VFX related expenses. So what is VFX intensive? That means 15% of the shots, or 1.5 shot per minute on the whole, within the project must include VFX. That isn't so hard to reach. What about the VFX related spends? Well, expenses have to be carried out by a service provider established in France, and they're related to the digital processing of shots. In short, the bill of the French VFX vendors. And all expenditures that occur during the filming and that are directly linked to the VFX process.
So, in order to qualify, your project must, one, be a live action fiction film. Animation project don't qualify. It had to include a substantial amount of digital visual effects. So please note at least 15% of total number of shoots, or on an average of 1.5 shoot per minute, are subject to digital processing. You have to include 2 million of eligible expenses related to the digital processing of shoots. And you have to pass a test. So there is two ways if fresh expenditure is principally related to digital visual effects. Then the VFX test will be used. And if French expenditure is principally related to non-VFX expenditures, it has to pass the test live action and shoot for at least 5 days in France. And you have to know that green screen filming counts.
So more than 300 projects have already benefited from the trip in its 10 years or so of existence. Here are a few examples. Just a quick recap on the kinds of projects that from now on could get the 40% tax rebate. They are VFX only projects of over 2 million euros in spends. Live action films which are shooting at least 5 days in France and where more than 2 million are spent in VFX made by one or several French VFX vendors. But if your project is not one of these, you will still have the 30% tax rebate, as 55 projects did last year, for example. That includes French Dispatch, that we're still waiting to see in cinemas.
Thank you, Matthew. So here we are. You will find our contact during all the festival. Don't hesitate to set up a meeting with us, and we'll provide you more information regarding your project.
Thank you very much. Thank you
very much.
for this. So we had a few questions that that were answered during the the talk. Maybe you have some other ones. Maybe you could just drop your questions in the Q&A box, which is at the bottom of your screen. And I had some question. I'm putting it in the conversation box. It's about our Film France pavilion. So I'm dropping the direct link here. Okay, so maybe you're gonna talk about co-productions now. Magali, can I ask you to give us some information about co-productions?
Yes, okay. Thank you, Stefan. Merci, Laurie. Merci. Voilà.
Oh.
Can you see the PowerPoint?
Okay. Yes, we can see it.
Myself.
We're just having some questions that arrived in the question box. So just please keep in mind that we're going to answer to them at the end after Magali will have presented the PowerPoint. Okay, so we're going to take care of them. The questions are going to be answered later.
Okay. Okay, so now I will talk about international co-production. So another possibility to work with France is actually to co-produce. And in the next few minutes, I will try to show you why is it interesting for you to co-produce, what does it consist of, and what are the funding, in particular the public funding dedicated to international co-production. So, the first slide is just to show you some facts. Actually, France is clearly a market for international co-production and for world cinema. So as you can see, so as you know, in Cannes every year we have a lot of co-production in selection. And a lot of French sales agents involved in this film. If we consider the facts of 2019 for theater, last year it was a normal year, we had almost 700 new films released in the cinemas in France, and half of them were non-French films. So France is a country very open to the diversity and for non-French and international co-production.
May I just interrupt you a little bit, Magali, because your sound is very low.
I'm sorry.
Just do something, maybe with your microphone, maybe if it's closer to your mouth. I'm sorry, but it's really that the sound is really low.
Okay, can you hear me now?
It's a bit better, yes.
It's not so good.
No, it's better, yes.
It's better.
Thank you.
Is it better now?
Yes, it is. It is.
Okay, so I will take off my micro. I thought it was better, but okay. Okay, France is the country that has the most bilateral agreements in the world. We have 58 bilateral co-production agreements with other countries. And in 2019, we have almost half of the qualified films or certified films that were international co-productions with 48 several different countries. So that just to tell you, to give you some facts about the interest that France is that co-production is the heart of French film industry. Because of TRIP, it's a very different system, a co-production regarding bilateral agreements or the European conventions. Why isn't it interesting for you to co-produce? So the first things is that your film has several nationalities. So it has then the nationality of each country. And that means that it gets some facilities to access to funding. Okay, to public funding, we will see later what is concerned. And for it can benefit to for TV channel to under in co-production in your project. You can then access to your image, the in European funding, and you can get to end your financing. You can get some financing contribution like Sofika. Of course, you had to respond the rules of the Sofika. And if you do an international co-production, you can access to automatic support for distribution in France. What are the obligations then? So if you are in the frame of a bilateral co-production agreement, you have to respect the term of this agreement. That means you have there is a share, a percentage of the financing part in each country, mostly is the minimum part has to be 20 or sometimes still 30, but mostly 20% for the minority co-producer, and for the European projects in co-production, this part has to be 10%. Sometimes you have some language criteria or some other criteria regarding the language, for example, but you really have to look at the international co-production agreement. The European Convention, we use it only from three countries in France, so it's not used only in bilateral co-production. And the other obligation is, of course, that the film has to be has to get the qualification. Certification, qualification mentioned before is the same. It's just another word used, but it's really the same. So that means you have to get this famous 25 points agreement. And for that, you have to do some expenses in France for salaries, technicians, actors, or in industry, etc. It's too short now to get into the grid and the point system, but of course we can have a discussion later on it if you are interested in. And there's two steps for this agreement, for this certification. One is the provisional before shooting, and then after the cinema release and the final cost, you get the final certification by CNC. It's not the same certification as for the trip, but there is a certification to recognize the international, official international co-production. Then it allows you to enter in international co-production. It allows you to access to public funding. And we have a lot of public funding in France, around 12 million. Euros every year, and 5 million is dedicated to the Aide au Cinéma du Monde. It's our selective scheme for international co-production for films that are in the non-French language, and it's open to all feature in co-production with France. We have some bilateral co-production for almost 3 million euros. And just a few words about your image. France invests every year around 4.5 million to the international co-production funding image. So a few words about Cinéma du Monde. The Cinéma du Monde is our selective scheme, famous now, it's very, very known. It's mostly for foreign directors. Actually, it can be for French directors, but then the film has to be in non-French language. It has to be a co-production with France. So we have four sessions every year, and around 90 applications per sessions. voilà, we are, you have to apply before shooting. And among these 90 projects, we have first a pre-selection. Around 30 projects are shortlisted, and then around 10 projects are supported. So every year, it's around 40 projects feature for productions, local productions supported. Then very short, just to tell you that we have bilateral co-production supports with Portugal, Tunisia, Italy, and Germany. And it's to encourage the co-production bilateral with, especially with these countries. General informations, because we don't have so much time, but regarding all this funding and since the Cinéma du Monde or bilateral supports, the project has to be feature projects, fiction, documentary, animation, so more than 60 minutes. And only Portugal, the bilateral funding with Portugal is open to short films. It's a subsidy. And 50% of the subsidy has to be spent in France. So has to be spent in France, that means has to be spent by the French producer. And it has to be like production cost or post-production costs. The application has to be made by the French producer or the producer established in France, who will be the beneficiary of the subsidy when the project is supported. The application, all the application, so the script notes has to be in French. The translation is very important in French. That's the job of your French producer too. And the contracts can be in English, of course, or in Spanish, but okay. The application has to be done before the start of the shooting. And yes, for Cinéma du Monde, we have language criteria. That means the language criteria, the language of the film has to be the language of the director or of the shooting place of the film. And we have a special rule for German, French, German, and with the phone with Germany or the phone with Italy, that France and Germany and or France and Italy has to be both majority partners if they are third partner on board. Okay, just when we talked with Stefan about the panel, we said it was maybe interesting to have like average amounts of the support, so to have an idea what you can put in your financing plan. So for Cinéma du Monde, the average amount is for fiction is 130,000 euro and 65,000 euro for documentary. And if you are not supported in production and you apply again in post-production, the average amount is 40,000 for post-production support. And now you have a new rule since last year regarding French initiative films. So if the film is a majority French film and the rights are in France and the budget is more than 2.5 million and you do a lot of expenses in France, you can go until 450 with an average of 300,000 euro. For the bilateral funding, Germany is the form is 3 million euro every year on the both sides together. And the average amount is 300,000 for a fiction, 150 for documentary. The thing is that the amount cannot be more than 20% of the budget and is capped at 500,000. For Italy, it's very new, the co-production fund with Italy. So now, after just one session, the amount was around 90,000 euro for production and 25,000 in development. Yes, Germany is Italy are open for development support too. Portugal is open to short films with 30 and 40,000 euro. And for feature films, the amount is around 120,000 for fiction, 43,000 for documentary. The bilateral fund with Tunisia is, the amounts are around 90,000 for fictions and 30,000 for documentary. And just a few words about your image. If you are in a bilateral co-production between a few countries of Eurimage, or if a country outside of Eurimage is less than 30%, you can access to Eurimage funding. Then what you can ask is maximum 17% of the budget, 25 for documentary, and it's capped as 500,000 euro, and it's to split. Some contacts for Cinéma du Monde. We have two boards. So the first board is for the first and second features of the director, and the second board is for more confirmed directors. And for the co-production support, we have three persons in my team for Germany and Italy, for Portugal and Tunisia. Voilà. And don't hesitate to contact us if you have any questions.
Thank you very much, Magali. Maybe just before answering to all the questions that were in the question box, maybe we can have a very few words about the regional fundings, because some of the French regional fundings are now open to co-production. Laurie, can you please give us a little?
Yeah, of course. I have to share my screen. So Magali, you have to.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Just one second.
Yeah.
We're just bringing up the slides.
It's there's been a lot of questions in the question box, and I tried to sort them out simply to have in order for you to have all the answers. Maybe there's a technical problem, and we're really sorry for this.
Okay. Okay.
Maybe we could have a word about the... Oh, okay. Thank you. Thank you, Laurie.
Okay, in addition of Magali's presentation, we have seven local regional firms that are available for co-production. So briefly, we have Brittany.
Yeah, Brittany, obviously in northwestern France, they have a fund for international co-development of feature films and audiovisual theories.
And you can contact Delphine Jouan.
Yeah.
Or Anne-Cécile Roland. Then you have Centre Val-de-Loire, Loire Valley. They also have a fund open to international co-production. Through a production partner established in the region, but it's mainly the same for all the regional firms. And you can contact Pierre Dallois.
In the Grand Est, Eastern France, we have a fund open to co-production with their neighbours, Belgium, Luxembourg, Germany and Switzerland. And the area is available for questions you may have.
We also have Film Paris Région, Île-de-France. We have a new 50% incentive to boost international co-production in the Paris region. Please feel free to contact with Stéphane Martinet and Mélène Thoman.
And then ALCA Nouvelle-Aquitaine in the southwest of France is a fund open to international co-production established with a production partner in the region.
Yeah. You can contact Nathalie Brémond.
And then Normandie Image, that's northern France. This, the fund is open to international co-production through a production partner, again, established in the region. Maria can answer any questions you have.
and south of France, Provence, Alpes, Côte d'Azur.
We have grants in the south for the development of feature films, documentaries, and TV films with international co-production.
And we can contact Vasilini Mermaris. Thank you so much. All the local film commissioner will be available just at the end of this presentation to talk with you. So, okay,
so thank you very much. So we have had a different questions that happened during this talk. Maybe there is one that could be answered right now. Is it's concerning the UK. I mean, you know, a lot of people asked if the cast and the crews would be eligible. Maybe you have an answer to this.
Yes, great answer.
As a fellow Brit, I have an answer. Fortunately, Britain is a signatory to
the World Convention
at a European level. So the EU has no effect on this. So that means that cast and crew are eligible if they're European. That makes no difference to the UK, whether it's in the EU or not.
So I cannot see Magali on the screen. Are you still with us, Magali?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, so we had a lot of questions about the different countries. We were asked if there's a bilateral agreement with Ireland. What about Ukraine? Maybe you can give us information about where to find the information about all the countries France has treaties with. Is there a one spot somewhere?
Yes, there is on the CNC website. But yes, I will try to, yes, maybe I will have to create a new address for general information. But until that, they can send us an email and we will forward the email to the person who is responsible. Maybe I will try to see where is it on the, to send you the link now, if it's possible. If I just have a few minutes to look at, because it's not so easy to find the page with a Google search. So maybe I will try to find it and put it in the chat.
And there are also questions about what happens when there is no bilateral agreement, and especially concerning the US.
US filmmakers have access to Cinéma du Monde, of course. So bilateral films, yeah, there's some country we have a special bilateral agreements, bilateral funds with them, but mostly you can access to Cinéma du Monde. Cinéma du Monde is really the universal, is open to every country in the world from the first feature. It's not open to short films, but I saw questions regarding, not directly regarding short films, but these bilateral funds are open to feature films. And Portugal is open to short films too, but the support in general at CNC for short films is open to international co-production. It doesn't have to be in French. You need to have a French producer, but the film can be shot abroad and can be in a non-French language. So the CNC system for short films is open to international co-production, and then you have for in the co-production with Portugal, you have especially a funds for short films, but it's a plus. But what was the question? Yes, and for the US, for example, yes, you can access to Cinéma du Monde. We have three projects already supported from US director. The thing is, to access to Cinéma du Monde, if you are in a country we don't have an agreement, a bilateral agreement with, and you're not European, then the budget has to be less than 2.5 million euros. And if the budget is less than 2.5 million euros, you can enter in co-production, but it's not an official co-production. It's like we call it more technical co-production. So you don't need to go to this certification, official certification. You don't need this 25 points, and but you can access to Cinéma du Monde. It's the same for Japan, for example. We don't have a bilateral agreement with Japan, but we have already supported Japan directors.
Yeah. There was another question about the can you get ACM at the Cinéma du Monde and have the tax rebate for international production? Who wants to answer to this?
No.
Laurie, Mathieu, can you please, with opening your sound? I think, okay.
Sorry, could you just repeat the question?
So the question was, is the tax rebate for international production available to, as an example, to a feature film who got Aide au Cinéma du Monde?
No, it's a short answer. The reason why is because there are two routes to filming in France, and those routes are very distinct and clear. You either choose a co-production route, for example, Aide au Cinéma du Monde, which qualifies the film officially as a French film. That makes it eligible to French subsidies, yeah, etc. The tax rebate is different in that you are not qualified as a French film. You remain an international production.
You don't share the rights.
Yes, exactly. So they cannot be compatible for legal reasons. Either do the tax rebate or you choose a co-production route.
You have to choose the right way.
Right.
I mean, obviously, we're here also to help you decide which is the best route for your particular project, and we can give you all the information, as can Magali, about the different options available.
We cannot hear you very well, Mathieu. Can you please just be a little bit closer of the microphone? The sound was very bad. Sorry for this.
My last point was we're, of course, here to help you work out which route is the best for your project, whether it's co-production. Magali can help you with that, and we can help you with the tax rebate.
As a producer, you are then in a very different positions regarding your project. So, you have to take the decision. It's very regarding each project. There's no rule, of course. But what I just wanted to add is for Cinéma du Monde is you can accumulate it with bilateral funds, for example. So within the co-production support scheme, you can add them. You can combine, accumulate them. You can have Cinéma du Monde and French-German mini treaty, or you can have Cinéma du Monde and French-Portuguese, if it makes sense. And and Eurimage, of course. Yeah.
So there were some other questions concerning. There's one that you answered to, which was, can a project combine different fundings? It is yes.
Yes.
There was a question, very technical question, about which was, how can you reach 25 points in a co-production minority French at 20%? Magali?
We come into the grid. You have 9 points for the French company, and for the other, it's if your director is French or non-French, if you have some heads, if you are doing the post-production, complete post-production in France, for example, you have to have this discussion with your French producer to see how to get the 25 points. For some projects or for some countries, you can have an exception to get only 20 points. Or sometimes 15 points. So you will. Now it's very in general. So you you have to see regarding your projects particularly, and which are the expenses that you could do in France, or it depends how many countries you have and how is your combination between the other supports you get in other countries and what are the obligations there. But it's possible to get 20 points or 25 points with a 20% share minimum. It's possible, yes.
Maybe Laurie and Mathieu, can you give us a little information about the cultural test, the French cultural for the tax rebate, which is different from the grid that applies to the production?
We've had a few questions regarding cultural test. We have a simulation of our cultural test on our website on the tax rebate section. It's called the Incentives Guide. This gives more information. Generally speaking, though, it's a points-based test that studies the dramatic content, first of all, of your project.
So location, characters.
Characters, plot and story, and the languages of the project. You gain a number of points, for example, if you have a relative majority of scenes that take place in France or a French-speaking country, or at least 5 scenes in France. So that gives you a very short view of the range of possibility to pick up points. It's very easy to pick up points. We then study elements of the cast and crew and also your technical facilities and how much you are using technical facilities based in France.
And it's different for animation? Maybe you can.
Yes, for animation, there is also information about the cultural test for animation projects. Obviously, that applies mainly to how much of your story. It doesn't necessarily have to be based in France. You can pick up points, for example, for a story that takes place in an imaginary universe, or
as the Minion, for example.
Yes, the Minions. Made entirely in French animation studios. So if you want more detailed information on the cultural test, of course, you're welcome to request a meeting with Laurie and me.
Yeah, we sent the link on all the Q&A. I don't know if everybody can saw it, but.
Yes, you will. You can always find us on the French Pavilion, which is in the market, under the institution section, and you can really contact us. We'll be online all week long. Just another question, which is a very practical one, is it was
Labar.
Can a UK film shoot 20% in France and get the tax rebate?
Yes, 20. Well, base is that the minimum requirements for the tax rebate is 250,000 euros minimum spend and 5 days shooting if it's a live action project. Obviously, 5-day minimum doesn't apply if it's animation. So that's just to bear in mind as a first point.
And another question to Magali this time, which is for the qualification as well. Daniel is asking about his project, which is spoken mostly in English, in a non-English speaking country. And he's asking, does this project qualify for Aide au Cinéma du Monde?
And the director is which nationality?
I don't know. Daniel, maybe you can, if you're still on the line. You can maybe add this, or maybe you could contact directly Magali to.
Yes, you can send us an email.
It's easier for this kind of Brazilian. His answering is Brazilian.
So it won't work. It has to. We have to see if for artistically reasons the English is used, or is it. For which reason? Yeah, let's extend. Maybe you can contact me. Don't hesitate to contact me, Daniel, and I will remember you. It's the first day. So we can have a talk about your project specifically if you want. And I have found a link to all co-production agreements on the CNC site. So maybe I will share it with everybody. And I saw some questions regarding African countries. Yeah. We have some scheme with for dedicated especially to French-speaking African country. And now we got last year the ACP support from Africa, Caribbean, Pacific. It's not the topic now on this conference, but if you want, if you're interested in this topic, tomorrow at 11:30 time from Paris, there will be a conference about ACP program and with the World Cinema Funds and CNC. Voilà, c'est l'Agence culturelle africaine who organize this panel. Just for information, because I saw some questions.
So there was
about Morocco, send me an email too, and we can have a talk about the discussions regarding Morocco too. No problem. Yeah.
And the one thing I have to simply say it again, the tax rebate is totally dedicated to international production, which means that it is totally impossible to combine it with the CNC support. It's really a choice you have to make, whether you decide to make your project a little bit French and get the CNC support, and then the tax rebate is totally not available, or you decide to keep it non-French, and then you can get the tax rebate for international production. Another thing I would just add, because we are going slowly towards the end of this session, is that we're having another session on Tuesday evening. It's at 7 p.m. French time. And it's going to be totally dedicated to the new VFX bonus. We had some questions, and we will be very happy to answer to them directly if you contact us on our pavilion or directly via our the Talk application. Really, do not hesitate to ask us for more details. But the other session will be more dedicated to the new VFX bonus.
So we look forward to this new information.
Yeah, I hope you will all be there. So thank you very much to all of you for having been with us today. Hope this was helpful. Hope you now have a lot of projects involving France in one way or another. And really do not hesitate to contact us, because we're going to be here online all week long. And really, we are here to connect, to share, to discuss with you, as in the real life Marché du Film. And so really, really do not hesitate. So thank you very much.
Daba from India, we will get in touch with you because you had a big project in France, and it seems that you can pass easily the project. So I will... Yeah.
Bombay, Berlin. Wow. Nice to see you.
So I just say it again, all our contacts are in the Meet and Match application, Talk an application. You can find us on the market. So Magali's email is there. And we, with all the Film France crew, have a pavilion, which we are totally reachable as well. And really, do not hesitate. If you don't find Magali's contact, just ask us and we will give it to you. And it's going to be a pleasure to talk with all of you. So thank you to our panelists, thank you to our audience, and see you soon in France. Thanks a lot.
Bye.